of you who are in the truth. I am going to be continuing on with video 13 of Spiritual Captivity, How to Tell Your Family. We are on my messenger, Malachi. Malachi 1. The message of the word of Yahuwah to Yasharal by Malachi. I have loved you, said Yahuwah. But you asked, in what way have you loved us? Was not Esau Yaakov's brother? Says Yahuwah, and I love Yaakov, but I have hated Esau and have laid waste his mountains and his inheritance for the monsters of the wilderness. If Adam says, we have been beaten down, let us return and build the ruins. Yahuwah Zavuot said thus, let them build, but I tear down, and they shall be called border of wickedness, and the people against whom Yahuwah is enraged forever. And your eyes shall see, and you shall say, great is Yahuwah beyond the border of Yasharal. A son esteems his father, and a servant his Adonai. And if I am the father, where is my esteem? And if I am Adonai, where is my respect? Said Yahuwah Zavuot. To you, priests who loathe my name. But you asked, in what way have we loathed your name? You are presenting corrupt food on my altar, but you asked, in what way have we corrupted you? Because you say, the table of Yahuwah is scornful. And when you present the blind as a slaughtering, is it not evil? Would he be pleased with you? No. Would he accept you favorably? Said Yahuwah Zavuot. And now entreat the face of all to show favor to us. This has been done by your hands. Would he show favor to you? Said Yahuwah Zavuot. Who among you would shut the doors so that you would not kindle fire on my altar for nothing? I have no pleasure in you, said Yahuwah Zavuot. Nor do I accept an offering from your hands. For from the rising of the sun, even to its going down, my name is great among Gaia, or nations. And in every place, incense is presented to my name, and a clean offering. For my name is great among Gaia, or among nations, said Yahuwah Zavuot. But you are profaning me in that you say, the table of Yahuwah is scornful, and its food is wretched. And you said, oh, what weariness! And you sneered at it, said Yahuwah Zavuot. And you brought in plunder and the lame and the sick, thus you have brought in the offering. Should I accept this from your hand? Said Yahuwah. But cursed be the deceiver who has a male in his flock and makes a vow, but is slaughtering to Yahuwah what is imperfect. For I am a great king. Roscoe! Said Yahuwah Zavuot, and my name is respected among Gaia. Get out. One second. Malachi 2. Sorry about that. And now, priests, this command is for you. If you do not fear, and if you do not take it to heart, to give esteem to my name, said Yahuwah Zavuot, I shall send a curse upon you, and I shall curse your blessings, and indeed I have cursed them, because you do not take it to heart. See, I shall rebuke your seed and scatter rubbish before your faces, the rubbish of your festivals, and you shall be taken away with it. And you shall know that I have sent this command to you as being my covenant with Louis, said Yahuwah Zavuot. My covenant with him was life and peace, and I gave them to him to fear. And he respected me and stood in awe of my name. The Torah of truth was in his mouth, and disobedience was not found on his lips. He walked with me in peace and straightness, and turned many away from error. For the lips of a priest should guard knowledge, and they seek the Torah from his mouth, for he is the messenger of Yahuwah Zavuot. But you have turned from the way. You have caused many to stumble in the Torah. You have corrupted the covenant of Louis, said Yahuwah Zavuot. And I shall make you despise and low before all the people, because you are not guarding my ways, and are showing partiality in the Torah. Have we not all one Father? Did not one all create us? Why do we act treacherously against one another? To profane the covenant of the fathers? Yehuda has acted treacherously, and an abomination has been done in Yasharal and in Yerushalayim, For Yehuda has profaned what is Kodesh to Yahuwah, what is holy to Yahuwah, which he had loved, and has married the daughter of a foreign mighty one. Let Yahuwah cut off from the tents of Yaakov the man who does this, stirring up or answering, and bringing an offering to Yahuwah Zebul. In this you have done a second time. You cover the altar of Yahuwah with tears, with weeping and crying, because he no longer regards the offering, nor receives it with pleasure from your hands. And you said, why? Because Yahuwah has been witness between you and the Ashah, or the wife of your youth, against whom you have acted treacherously, though she is your companion and the Ashah of your covenant, and did he not make one? So you shall guard your ruach. Wait, sorry. Shoot. And he had the remnant of the ruach.
I had to move it together.
And what is the one alone? Yeah. And he seeks a seed of Elohim. So you shall guard your ruach and let none act treacherously against the Ashah or the wife of your youth. For I hate divorce, said Yahuwah Zabul, or Yahuwah Elohim of Yasharal, and the one who covers his garment with cruelty, said Yahuwah Zabul. So you shall guard your ruach and do not act treacherously. You have wearied Yahuwah with your words, and you have said, in what way have we wearied him? In that you say, everyone who does evil is good in the eyes of Yahuwah, and he is delighted in them. For where is the Elohim of lawfulness? Malachi 3. See, I am sending my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me. Then suddenly Adonai, you are seeking, comes to his hakal, even the messenger of the covenant in whom you delight. See, he is coming, said Yahuwah Zabul. And who is able to bear the yom of his coming, or the day of his coming? And who is able to stand when he appears? For he is like the fire of a refiner, and like the soap of a launderer. And he shall sit as a refiner and a cleanser of silver. And he shall cleanse the sons of Lui and refine them as gold and silver. And they shall belong to Yahuwah, bringing near an offering in obedience. Then shall the offering of Yehuda and Yerushalayim be pleasant to Yahuwah, as in the Yomim of old, the days of old, as in former years. And I shall draw near to you for lawfulness, and I shall be a swift witness. No! No. And I shall be a swift witness. I'm sorry. Against the practicers of witchcraft, and against adulterers, and against them that swear to falsehood, and against those who oppress the wage earners in his wages, and widows and the fatherless, and those who turn away a traveler, and do not fear me. Said Yahuwah Zabul. For I am Yahuwah, I change not. And you, O sons of Yaakov, shall not come to an end. For the yomim of your fathers you have turned aside from my laws and did not guard them. Turn back to me, and I shall turn back to you, said Yahuwah Zabul. But you said, in what shall we turn back? Would a man rob Elohim? Yet you are robbing me. But you said, in what have we robbed you? In the tithe and the offering? And you have cursed me with a curse, for you are robbing me, this nation, all of it. Bring all the tithes into the storehouse, and let there be food in my house. And please examine me in this, said Yahuwah Zabul, whether I do not open for you the windows of the Shamayim, and shall pour out for you boundless blessings. And I shall rebuke the devourer for you, so it does not destroy the fruit of your ground. Nor does the vine fail to bear fruit for you in the field, said Yahuwah Zabul. And all Gaim shall call you blessed, for you shall be a land of delight, said Yahuwah Zabul. Your words have been harsh against me, said Yahuwah. But you have said, what have we spoken against you? You have said, it is worthless to serve Elohim. And what did we gain when we guarded his charge? And when we walked as mourners before Yahuwah Zabul. And now we are calling the proud blessed. Not only are the doers of lawlessness built up, but they also test Elohim and escape. Then shall those who fear Yahuwah speak to one another, and Yahuwah listen and hear. And a book of remembrance be written before him of those who fear Yahuwah and those who think upon his name. And they shall be mine, said Yahuwah Zabaoth, on the yom that I prepare a treasured possession. We are his treasured possession. And I shall spare them as a man spares his own son who serves him. Then you shall again see the difference between the obedient and the lawless, between one who serves Elohim and one who does not serve him. My messenger, Malachi 4. For look, the yom shall come burning like a furnace, and all the proud and every lawless one shall be stubble. And the yom that shall come shall burn them up, said Yahuwah Zabaoth, which leaves to them neither root nor branch. But to you who fear my name, the servant of obedience shall arise with healing in his wings. And you shall go out and leap for joy like calves from the stall. And you shall trample the lawless ones, for they shall be ashes under the soles of your feet on the yom that I do this, said Yahuwah Zabaoth. Remember the Torah of Moses, my servant, which I commanded him in Korah for all Yasharah, laws and directives. See, I am sending you Aliyah, the prophet, before the coming of the great and awesome Yom or Day of Yahuwah. And he shall turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and the hearts of the children to their fathers, lest I come and smite the Eretz or the earth with utter destruction. Sorry. Introduction to the Nazarene writings. Yeah, the dogs aren't being very good. Our big dog is being very bad. But introduction to the Nazarene writings. How to prepare for the end is explained here very clearly. Note that the preparation for the return of Yahusha at the time of the day of Yahuwah is preceded by the warning given at Malachi 4. To remember the Torah of Moshe, Moses. Specifically, this is the 10 words of his covenant. When these commands are obeyed and lived by Yahusha's Nazarene, we are accused of being legalists, as if legalism is heresy. Good is called evil, and evil is called good. Everyone should strive to be lawful, not lawless. BYNV Hebrew Roots Dictionary of Critical Words. And that's right there. Nazarene writings. The Nazarene writings in this version are arranged in an order that better presents Yahusha as a Torah teacher. In fact, the living Torah, the word of life, Torah being the light of the world, the living word of Yahuwah was previously with his people. Yahuwah is doing a new thing. Now the Ruach of Yahuwah has come to dwell in the people, in his people. His mind or Torah is alive in us who obey his word. In the beginning, Bereshit is announced a second time, since the Nazarene writings reflect the light and announce the coming of the true light. His first followers warn us of a coming falling away from the belief. There is also a hint in Shaul's writings of a future standing away or apostasia, which occurs in the last days. The Nazarene of today are standing away from the malicious teachers and the strongholds they have imprisoned so many minds within for centuries. Yahusha's first followers were trained in Torah observance from their childhood. But in Yahusha, they met the living, breathing Torah, the instructor himself. Torah means instruction, and Torah instructs us in how to love Yahuwah and our neighbor. Yahusha's living obedience to the living words is our best guide to follow him and walk as he walked. The traditional mindset repels obedience, so hopefully by this new arrangement of these memoirs, new readers will first be warned against falling away from the Torah. The first followers were servants, and they want to teach you many things traditional teachers want you to disregard. I don't think so. I don't have it. Open your heart and listen to their words. They are words of love. The author of the book of John does not give his name directly, only indirectly. Inferred from the phrase, the pupil whom Yahusha loved. Oh my God. He wrote this in his later years, but in the account he provides us, his identity happens to be the young brother of Miriam and Martha, whom Yahusha raised from the dead. You will see this to be true as you read it carefully to the end of the account. So what is his name?
Lay down, rascal.
It happens to be Alazar, Elohim helps, also commonly known as Lazarus.
Lay down.
Several of the Nazarene had two or even three names.
Wow. I can't believe
Rascal. Since the rulers
were seeking to
kill Alazar as well as Yahusha, it is possible he began to use one of his other names as an alternate.
Leave her alone.
In order to remain anonymous to their plot. This is only a theory of the editorial staff. The Paleo-Hebrew you will see in the text represents the authentic letters which spell the name Yahusha. Yahusha's name means, I am your deliverer. The transliterations, I've showed this table before, but if you haven't seen this before or you're new to the channel, Yahuwah was found 6,823 times in the Torah. Yahuwah, I mean, if I said Yahusha. Rascal! Yahusha was found 216 times. Yahushua was found twice, and Yeshua was found once.
No, you cannot have her, rascal.
That is the table. At Hebrews 4 and Acts 7, the same Greek lettering is used for Joshua and Jesus. I-H Seus. This is confirmation both were called Yahusha in Hebrew. What's missing? Why is Yahusha's spirit not received by many people? The lack of obedience prevents people from receiving him. Acts 5:32 explains it. The spirit is only given to those who obey him. Obey Yahusha. What did you know and when did you know it? He made known to you his covenant, which he commanded you to do, the 10 words, and he wrote them on two tablets of stone. Deuteronomy 4:13. I am the vine, you are the Nazarene. Yehukim 15:5. You can find this at TorahZone.net. Rascal, go. And I will be finishing up the lesson on this book tomorrow or later on. Next time I'll be talking about obedience, the key of knowledge. And I will be talking about, we are in the last days, and is Yahusha a Pharisee?
Rascal, we made this little area so you won't be doing this. Come on, buddy.
I love you all. Shalom and blessings.
Sorry, everybody.